Parental discretion is advised.
Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show 305 from Mayhem Studios right here in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I am Sorgatron. That's who I am. And we got a special show planned somewhat, sort of, for you guys tonight. With me on the couch, as usual, is Chachi. ChachiPlays.com.
ChachiPlays.com.
Nowhere else but ChachiPlays.com.
You cannot get to anywhere on the internet without going to ChachiPlays.com and hitting the donate button.
That's right. Chachi, if there's a good place I want to donate money to help the arts, where would I go to?
ChachiPlays.com.
Donate. No, ChachiPlays.com.
Yes.
So that's let me get this right. That's www.ChachiPlays.com, and then I just hit that little yellow donate button, and I can donate.
You said donut.
Yes. I keep saying yes. It's so easy to say donut. I just click that, and I can donate money to help kids with arts and stuff like that.
Correct.
ChachiPlays.com.
Your simplistic description of it is, I guess, right.
I guess right.
And there he is, trying to get a grasp on the charities in the English language, and eating his title is the Wrestlefan.
Nom nom, ChachiPlays.com. Hi, how's it going?
That rhymed.
It did.
And also from the dark side, DJ Lunchbox.
Hey, what's up? It's cold over here up in this motherfucker. I'm DJ Lunchbox, and I'm going to say monsterhaiku.org, but I don't want to step on Chachi's fundraising, so I'll also say ChachiPlays.com.
That's right. And then go to monsterhaiku.org, which is also a great cause.
Yeah, which is also a fundraising effort.
Yes.
That's true, but, you know, it's not... I mean, the store is not open yet, so I'm not going to plug it real hard because you're going to get real sick of it here on the Mayhem Show when I start plugging that motherfucker real
Everybody wants to
real
be me.
Real hard.
That's right.
Everyone wants to be me.
And also coming at us, it's Bobby FJ Town. How you doing?
Hey, how's it going? Also making his triumphant return to the show to teach Wrestlefan the difference between 2-2 and 2, Puppet FJ Town.
Hello.
Oh, you went black. There he is.
Oh, he's back.
Also joining us, the Rizz.
Hey, guys. This is the Royal Rumble coming up. I got this going right now. I don't know if you can see that. I'm about to play this one more time.
Are you playing it during the show?
During the show.
Okay, you're going to give us updates?
Oh, nice.
Yes.
Is this your scientific assessment of how the Royal Rumble will go this Sunday?
Well, last night, Tyson Kidd won.
Okay.
So I'm trying to see if it happens again.
Fairly accurate.
Okay.
It's accurate. So I'm going to press play right now.
Excellent. And join us, a special guest tonight, Michael Facade, the newest Super Indy Champion in IWC.
Yo, your favorite neighborhood suburban terrorist. How's it going?
All right. Thank you for joining us again.
Thank you for having me.
Excellent. So we'll be talking with you about Pure Talent is this Sunday. Or no, Friday. I don't know my days. This Friday. We'll be talking about that, of course, where you take on Matthew Justice. Yes. And we have some other questions from the fans and stuff we'll be getting into, too. Here shortly. What are you doing, Chachi?
Looking at Super Mario Brothers 3 in the new in the box.
No, I'm
you know,
looking.
You know where they can get a chance to play Super Mario Brothers 3?
Shut up. No, I'm looking for a box.
Okay.
Or ChachiPlays.com.
I have the game. I just need the box.
Weird. Okay.
He's gonna bring it with him.
Can you buy just the box?
I'm sure you can, but the value of the game goes up 100% if you have a box.
Truth.
To $10?
Actually, for Super Mario Brothers 3, it would go from like 3 to 30.
Hmm.
So.
The more you know.
All right, guys. Anyways, this is the Wrestling Mayhem Show.
Not that any of that has to do with this show.
We just talk about video games randomly, but that's what happens. You can also contact us. Well, you can come check us out at WrestlingMayhemShow.com after you've gone to ChachiPlays.com. Or you can also email us at...
Good times!
At WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can tweet us at Mayhem Show. You can drop us a line on our voicemail at 412-206-WMS0. That's 412-206-9670. Please keep them short so we can play them on the show. Please. As much as you can. Please follow us on our Facebook.
Don't yell.
Don't yell at us. Don't yell at us. Oh, and there's the app right there that Rizz is holding up. The WMS Gold is $1.99 on your Apple stores, your Kindle store and app stores, and your Android app stores. And I see the reflection of your Royal Rumble going on.
Shawn Michaels is number one, by the way. There you go.
Of course he is. And of course, we're on Facebook. We're on the open groups there. We've got a lot of great discussion going on. Over on Google Plus, we're watching Raw together and Hangouts every Monday night, and sometimes for pay per views too. And make sure you bookmark us on the YouTube, on Blip TV, on not MediaFly. That's not going to be a thing anymore. Stitcher Radio, iTunes. We're all over the place. Mevio.com as well. You know, first thing we do is get into the fan mail. So we got a pretty good one here from Sonic Screwjob. I think LB is going to take it away. You're not LB. The
title of this email is, I dedicate this email to AJ because I really appreciate her. I set that shit down. Okay. Salutations, Mayhem crew. I was away from town this weekend and had to play catch up with my episodic wrestling fix in one dose. My first observation is that Impact and SmackDown, when watched consecutively, will leave your brain's logic centers...
Are you okay over there?
Say the word.
Computing.
And susceptible to impulse buys. I didn't really need any audio and shadow insurance, antidepressants, and I already have pirate-themed spice rum, so TNA sponsors could be wasting their time. So here's a couple of thoughts. Has WWE invested in some acting coaches? These would be people who coach others in the finer points of thespianism. I want to thank you, Sonic Screwjob, for knowing about pronunciation problems and spelling it out. Anyway, not a person who coaches until the regular guy comes back. Anyway, the quality of storytelling is on an upswing in WWE right now. Daniel Bryan cut a great opening on SmackDown. Ziggler is smoking promos on Raw. Heck, even Justin Gabriel told a decent story in the ring with Cody Rhodes instead of his usual spot monkey tactics.
Monkey spots.
It just appears that WWE has crossed over from, quote, fine talent to, quote, refined talent modes, a trend that I hope continues. A couple of points the coaches need to cover with the writers are, number one, don't give Brodus Clay the microphone. And importantly, number two.
I disagree. I want to say give him the microphone more. Come on.
Number two, Regal dance.
Sorry, you're breaking up there. It says don't let Stephen Regal dance.
Oh, yes. Come on.
That was awesome.
Let the Brit dance.
Yeah. Come on.
I agree. Make it happen.
And then...
And Rosa Mendez? Is it Menendez?
Yeah,
it's Mendez. Mendez were those little fuckers who fucked each other and killed their parents.
No, he just decided to spell it with a Z. Wow. But it's really spelled with an S.
College boy.
Listen, can we get back?
I'm Mexican, Rosa, I know how to spell Mendez.
Shut up.
Can we go back to the Regal dancing thing for a minute?
Okay. Sure. Number two, don't let Steven Regal dance.
Okay. Number one, yes, let him dance. And then number two, and you can only do number one if you have number two, but let him talk about him dancing at a later date.
They got him on Raw. What's the last time you've seen him on Raw?
Right. If he's not commentating his own dance moves, he's not allowed to dance. But that's, yeah. You can't have one without the second.
Rosa gets points for, well, being Rosa, but Regal looked like a shock therapy treatment gone awry. I have to give kudos to Regal in the, quote, I will sell this crap writing if it's the last thing I do category. On the subject of the Funkasaurus, is it just me or is Brodus Clay being booked like a diva? I know I'm in the minority with my disdain for Clay, but think about it. Big music, extended entrance, two high spots with a finisher for a 90-second match, and then, excuse me, extended celebration with big music. Divas match. To prove my point, neither Raw or SmackDown had a Divas match since Clay re-debuted. Clay is big right now, and since Ryder is apparently going on the shelf for a while, WWE should be priming him for a feud at the very least. By the way, I got a text that said Zack Ryder broke his back. Come on! Yep. That's a little extreme.
That's what they said.
And he got chokeslammed to hell. So
that's right.
By God. By God.
Hell being under the stage.
Yeah. Under the stage. It was Kane, so it was hell.
Speaking of Zack Ryder, I know he's fodder for the Kane / Cena storyline, but he's the number two face right now. Why shelf him when he's a crowd favorite? Those Slurpee cups ain't gonna sell themselves, you know.
They're not shelving him. He's gonna miraculously come back for the Royal Rumble
from a broken back.
Right.
He's gonna come back with a Kane mask on, and Kane's gonna start making disciples.
Oh, that would be awesome. Ooh,
wouldn't it be super fucking awesome? Ooh. That's why they won't do it. Anyway, Chris Jericho. He's one of my favorites, but I'm going to emulate him and not say anything about his story arc. The CM Punk angle is playing out pretty good, but let me get this straight. Johnny Laurinaitis is forced to call Punk / Ziggler straight down the middle, against his will, mind, because he's going to be evaluated by the guy that was forced out of the GM spot because of a no-confidence walkout. Bring back the anonymous general manager. Oh, yeah. While I'm on this, I didn't get the warm, fuzzy Austin McMahon satisfaction with Punk slapping around Big Johnny. Probably because Laurinaitis looks like he's 90 and moves like the Tin Man before Dorothy hit him with the oil can. You know, kind of sounds like him, too. Have a great show, guys. Sonic Screwdriver. P.S. Someone needs to tell Hunico that a cool bicycle only makes the rider cool if he's under 10 years old. PSS, I like Kane's new finisher. I think I'm going to call it the I Got Your Nose, or maybe the Honk Honk.
Excellent.
I was just going to say that email seemed to be too long, and right as I was going to say that, it ended.
Perfect.
So, and the bicycles.
Yeah, it worked well.
So I think that's it for our emails this week as far as non-interview versions.
Was there an email from AJ?
Oh, there's one from AJ. That's right.
She snuck it
here,
in.
I'll throw this on there.
He should ride the Pee Wee Herman bicycle.
Unico?
No, yeah. That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Put the line on the front.
AJ wrote us last week. AJ... as in AJ and PGH that's been on the show, not AJ.
You know what?
It's AJ style.
There's another one, too.
Is there another one?
Yeah.
I spoke with the guy smoking the bong on the Google Hangout last week about real weed, fake weed, and WWE policies on them. The guy thought about it deeply, paused for a moment, and said, wait, what? I'm glad AJ's doing some research for us.
No, I think he wanted you to say it like this.
Hmm.
Wait. What? I think that's what he wanted.
Oh, okay. Okay, I got it.
You got it?
I got you.
Continue.
Oh, that was it, actually. that was the end.
Continue.
It was the end. Did you say there was another one that slipped in?
Yeah, it came in on Thursday.
On Thursday?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's from Pierre Kelly.
Oh.
To the WMS Nation. If the classic arcade term "winners don't use drugs" rings a bell, Evan Airhead Bourne would be a poster child for the slogan, as he served two wellness program suspensions in two straight months. What in the name of Magnum TA did Evan do to deserve this mess? He was one half of Air Boom, became tag champs overnight, and now E suspends him twice for drug and/or alcohol use. Really? Really? I mean, come on. Why can't high flyers in WWE get punished for violating the policy? You got Sin Cara, Rey Mysterio Jr., Jomo, and now you can add Bourne to the list. All he's missing is the Royal Rumble and the Elimination Chamber, but he may return for WrestleMania. And if he does it again, TNA, or Impact Wrestling, is calling. Let's hope that doesn't happen again. See you guys later. Pierre K., a.k.a. Mr. Techwood Drive.
Sent from my iPod. iPod?
Yes, iPod.
Oh, touch. That's right.
He's got the touch.
Boy.
Yeah, and there's also stories going around that even after his suspension, he's probably going to be done with the company. So,
It sounded like he was upset at WWE for suspending.
Yeah, the email read as if he's mad that the high flyers are getting suspended. But you know what? If you're mad at the High Flyer or WWE for suspending the High Flyers,
yeah, there's nothing.
Maybe
to do with
they shouldn't what they be are. High.
And it's not yeah. like Mysterio's been suspended before. I think. Like
yeah,
like back when they first started it, when they had that.
Yeah,
big
but that was
thing.
Probably for steroids.
Yeah, because it was that doctor that came out after the yeah. Benoit thing, and there was like 12 of them that got suspended for a month.
Right.
So I mean, it's not
that's,
like
that was different drugs.
Yeah, I don't think WWE's victimizing the small high flyers of the company by any means.
No, put the pipe down.
Yeah, I mean, this is a whole other thing
right.
entirely. So
hugs, not drugs.
I don't get suspended for 30 days if I get caught smoking illegal drugs in my office or going to work.
Well, maybe you should.
Wait, smoking illegal drugs in your office? Wouldn't you just get fired for that?
Exactly. Even if
oh, they found me in the janitor's closet smoking pot.
Even if I failed,
I was going to say, why aren't you?
Even if I failed off. A piss test, I would get fired. I wouldn't get suspended for 30 days.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't eat poppy seed muffins.
Guys. Right. Stay off the drugs.
Stay off the gazelle antlers.
Exactly.
You have a job that pays you a lot of money.
Beep.
Maybe you should go without some weed. I'm just. Throwing that out there.
Maybe.
Yeah, that's a good point. You've reached your what is ostensibly your life's goal. You're in the big leagues. This is your big shot. You know full well how temperamental this company is and the fact that they could fire you tomorrow for nothing. So you're giving them a reason to fire you tomorrow.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Not the wisest maneuver on the part of young Mr. Bourne.
Hey, you know what? Do what a lot of other wrestlers do after they're done wrestling. Go have a beer.
Go fuck a ring rat.
That too.
Yeah.
There needs to be more ring rats in WWE. There'd be less weed. That's what I learned this week from the Wrestling Mayhem show.
All right.
Don't do drugs.
Exactly. I think that is the last of our fan mail.
Yeah, that was
okay.
It.
Okay, another one.
That's the for real last.
That was
the
for real.
Yeah, I don't.
It was weird because they all kind of trickled in. I usually get them in like a barrage right before the show. And
yeah, I don't even know why.
From like last week,
I don't even remember, or I can't figure out how I remembered that.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks
because
for
you're high.
Oh
no, I'm not high.
Burn.
All right.
The problem.
All right. So, like I said, we got our guest here, Mr. Michael Facade.
Who's, I gotta say, and I'm not gonna have him adjust it, because it's kind of cool, but his belt is in the white, so it's hitting me in the eye. Which is why I'm not looking
it's
at him.
Shiny.
Like, I'm trying to look this way, or away from it, but I noticed I don't know where you put the bag that you carry it in. But it's like this leopard print bag.
That's Wildcat's fancy pants.
There it is. Yeah, it's over there. But yeah, it's nice and shiny.
Nice. So,
and Chachi looks down.
I can't help
it. So Chachi keeps looking at his crotch, you know. So, Facade, how you been? It's been a while since you've been on the show.
A minute, yes, indeed.
I think the last time you were here, Shima was doing a Baby Batista post.
Baby Batista running in and out of the room like a madman.
Yeah, yeah. Now he's on TNA. We see Mayhem Bump. So.
Yeah.
And you,
sorry,
you're
Rinka King.
You're the Super Indy Champion. So, how's it been in the last month in luxury there?
Super Indy Champion.
Now, did they not let you spray paint this one?
Let me. We'll see what happens.
Exactly. So you had a pretty crazy match. The last winner takes all IWC in December, a 4-way ladder match. How many ladder matches have you been involved in?
Well, it's hard to say. Between ladder matches and TLC matches, it's been like maybe. Five or six, I'd say.
Mm-hmm.
And just the past year or so, it's been like three of them. So, yeah. Remix Pro, I captured the first ever Remix heavyweight title. And that was back in November. And then now here with IWC, taking back the Super Indy title from its vacant position.
That's right. And we love our ladder matches, but you know, we see the toll. I mean, was there anything Didn't you take a pretty rough one off a ladder, like through a ladder on the outside?
There was something. I kind of have bad luck with these. One time, I kind of almost died trying to put Jimmy DeMarco through a ladder riding.
Didn't that make it into his music video?
Yeah.
Yeah, there were a lot of notes of use this because the ninja dies. Yeah. I don't know. And then he draws a penis by it.
Yeah, that time I kind of missed the ladder and him entirely and rode that chair to, like a magic carpet down to the ground, breaking my butt. But this time, actually, I just hit the ladder and it kind of crushed and caved in around me.
Mm-hmm.
And then Logan Shulo double stomping me into a ladder and also me being crushed into being surrounded by metal works.
Jeez. Jeez.
Madness.
So, and I have some a few questions. Well, first we got it. We came across your picture as we were doing our indie coverage. As we try to do, we try to reach out to different groups. We saw your picture pop up here, and I'll bring it up with Urban Wrestling Federation.
Wrestling Federation.
We played some promos on here just like out of curiosity.
The hood is the new block.
Can you explain this to us? What is?
Yes, as an insider, please fill us in on this.
And how did you become involved? Well,
it's a man's game now. You see,
okay,
that's one of the mottos with the Urban Wrestling. Let's see. How do they describe it? They say it's Grand Theft Auto meets professional wrestling. I kid you not, my man.
Perfect combo.
I mean, all right. We did the first set of pay-per-views. There was three pay-per-views that have been out. And I think it was this Sunday, the Thug Assassins, appropriately named for the OG Thug Assassin right here. But Thug Assassins pay-per-view debuted Sunday, and they're repeating it over and over the rest of the month. But the thing with the Urban Wrestling, like one of the things that happened, there's been a shooting. There's been carjackings.
Holy shit.
I mean, shit goes down in the Urban Wrestling Federation. It's kind of like the first sets of stuff. The first set of stuff was at the Hammerstein Ballroom, and some things were set. Like there was a alleyway death match. There was a New York street fight, which was like in a nightclub. But then now these new ones, they're all in this nightclub, and it's like Def Jam Vendetta, like the video game. It's pretty insane. I mean, it's awesome. It's got gritty realism and like an assortment of rappers. It's like, say, the Warriors. Everybody's got a gang, everybody's got a crew, and everybody's got their leaders, you know, and these leaders are these rappers. They got Cuban Link, Uncle Murder. Used to be in a crew with like Melly Mel and Red Cafe, but now they got me with these dudes, Gunplay and Torch, some guys out of Chicago and stuff. There's lots of crazy stuff going on there. Lots of hard hitting. Lots of a new edge on extreme. You know what I mean? Like, but it's some wild stuff. It's some R-rated stuff, but it's crazy.
And we don't really see that like on like the national, I don't say national television side, but you know we don't see much of that kind of ECW side like on TV, and then this is on pay per view.
Right. Well, the thing is too, like national pay per views, like you get your TNA or your WWE pay per views, but it's funny you mentioned the ECW style because it's actually one of the guys heading up the Urban Wrestling is Steve Carroll, who's been involved with the early days of ECW with like Todd Gordon and Paul Heyman and those guys.
Mm-hmm.
And then also to add to the extreme credentials, they have Kevin Kleinrock and some of those guys from XPW. And I mean, some crazy, some banana stuff, man.
Awesome. I guess they say they're on pay-per-views. They said the third one's probably running now.
Yeah,
it's one of those where like I know like the Dragon Gates, like they run like for a month or something, right? So I mean, there's always a chance to catch it.
Yeah. Urban,
sort of speaking about like ECW and stuff like that, I know you also work for a company, Absolute Intense Wrestling, and this was since you've been on the show last, you had a match with Sabu at one of their past shows. How did that sort of go? I would think it's obviously like it would be a dream match.
It definitely was a dream match in many ways, but you know, with every dream there's reality, and that match, by far, it could have. There's a lot of things that could have gone better with it, But, you know, all things considered, I think the match that I did have with him was really well. And, you know, there was a lot of doubters of, that Sabu this, can't do that. But you know what? Sabu can still go. He still got it. And, you know, I look forward to working with him again. You know, one more.
I see he's doing stuff now in like Dragon Gate and some other companies, like especially like with the last ECW Arena show. Yeah. I wonder if he'll be sort of making his rounds.
As long as he stays healthy, you know what I mean. He's still a madman.
I remember he wasn't wrestling for a bit, and like ICP were doing benefit shows that try to cover his hospital bills and everything. Yeah. So I mean, but he's done so much crazy stuff.
Yeah, I mean, like,
it takes a toll.
Yeah, I mean, just two weeks ago, at the end of the last, he had at the time the very last match in the arena. Him and Justin Credible closed out the arena.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And that was a pretty insane match in itself too.
Mm-hmm. Now, I mean, looking at, you know, obviously, you know, we were talking about Sabu and. You know, in his state of his career and the crazy stuff he's done, you have more of a high flyer, high risk, you know, do a lot of crazy stuff. Like we talked about the ladder match. I know you've done some stuff in CZW.
I love to get cray cray.
So do you think about that? Like looking at Sabu and like the condition he's in now and the history he's had, do you consider that with where you're going with it in your future and how you kind of go about these sorts of matches?
I mean, it's hard to say because I see the effects that it's had on people with that kind of style of professional wrestling. But see, I mean, he's a tough son of a bitch, and that's one thing that he always did. He would wrestle and go through with things. No matter how banged up he was still pushing forward, still going, mm-hmm. you know, still making awesome matches. But, you know, I think there's times and places where you do need to just step back and let yourself recover. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the things that I've really try to take care of myself whenever I can, every little bit of extra time that I can rest and try not to hurt myself, but just to be cognizant of my injuries. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? And, you know, even still, I mean, it hasn't really changed my style so much because I dress to impress. I'm trying to get everybody out there, man. I'm trying to put asses in the seats. You know what I mean? Women, infants, children. Happy fellas.
Excellent. We also saw you this past summer. Wrestlefan was visiting from Texas. We came up there for Resolution. And I've been saying, like, I got a comment. I know he was out earlier in the afternoon, but you did have a longer line than Kevin Nash in intermission, sir.
Kevin Nash, big sexy. I don't know what to say about that.
Not the bash on Kevin Nash. But.
I don't know what to say about that. It is true. There was a lot of, the smiling faces, the little kids.
Mm-hmm. You get a lot of kids these days.
I mean, I try to hit it from all angles, man. Mm-hmm. Like, and like, I don't. I hope I'm doing it right. I
try to too.
But you know what I mean. With friendly with the kids, the ninja gimmick's way over with the kids.
Oh yeah.
And I mean, like, I'm not afraid to put myself out there and die for everyone. And I mean, I think that conveys to like the real wrestling fans, you know. But as far as Kevin Nash, I think afterwards, like, he shook my hand and he took some time to talk to me. I think I might have maybe not taken his eye, or just maybe kind of earned a little bit of his respect. And you know, mm-hmm. That says a lot. Cause
hey, he did tutor the X division for a while there.
Yeah. So. So I mean, like, anytime that I can not only make a good impression, but to get some good advice or anything that, you know, can help me, you know, keep me going. You know what I mean? It's always really appreciated. And then to see him, not only that, like the next week on pay-per-view.
Mm.
Awesome.
Also,
I got one.
Well, yeah, go ahead.
Mad Mike would like to know, if you could tag any worldwide landmark, what would it be?
Oh, man. I mean,
that's like tougher than your favorite match.
That is such a question. I would want to say I'd want to do something to the Statue of Liberty, like put a bandana on her face or something like that, just like a giant bandana. Because I mean, I wouldn't want to permanently deface the Statue of Liberty because I'm all about liberty, and you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. But no, if I could write something cool, I would definitely, I would have to be on like the Washington Monument, just like that big thing's a alien antenna anyway. So I mean, reflecting pool with an alien antenna.
Like in Transformers. Exactly. We got a few more from fans here. If you could tag... he says, if I can hire him to take down the murdering bastard David R. DeMira. So you know David R. DeMira is the one that killed the one Doc Remedy that used to be on the show.
Oh, I got a remedy for David DeMira.
Yeah.
It's taking him to Spin Kick City. Spin kicks, backflips, rope walks, dreadlocks. I've actually had a match with him at Black Diamond.
Okay.
It's been a year now.
Mm-hmm.
And you see a side of me that you don't normally get to see everywhere, and that's the bad guy facade, some shin facade, if you will. And he had an enjoyable time.
Excellent. Which match besides Jimmy and Fab are you looking forward to at Pure Talent this Friday?
As much as I'd hate to say it, I look forward to seeing what Jason Gore has to do. See if he can hang and bang with the hot young sensation in Aiden Vale, the young rookie. But you know what? I don't think he can help the kid. Because
mm-hmm.
I think Aiden Vale's the better man at this point in time. Jason Gorey's out of his head.
And he has drumsticks.
He has drumsticks. You know what I mean?
So we know you're such a big fan of the Pocket Rockets.
He's not. No, the Pocket Rockets are dead.
They're dead. Who's
absolutely.
JT?
JT who?
I don't think. I think it's going to be a good match, but that's my vote. For match of the year.
Speaking of Jason Gorey, obviously, you know, everything that happened the last show with IWC where he jumped you at the end of the show, the video is up there on IWCWrestling.com if you want to check that out. But there's a little preview coming up in PWO. It's going to be on TV in a few weeks where you get to meet him. So outside IWC, and he's doing some crazy stuff over there in PWO.
See, me and Jason Gorey, that at this point, our feud has gotten so far out of control that it's spilled over to many other promotions. Mm-hmm. I mean, I can't go anywhere without seeing his face and wanting to put my foot into that face of his. A little grueling. He got the blood dripping from his face, and he's got all this demonic intentions. And you know what? PWO was just a taste of what you're going to see in IWC.
Mm-hmm.
Because one of these days, he'll work his way around. He'll have to start at the bottom and, you know, work his way up. But, you know, whenever he does, I'll be waiting for him. And by that time, there's no way he's taking the Super Indy title from me. And I'll be taking his PWO TV title from him.
Hey, so this has been a big change around, like, first time I saw, like, I think it was RWA, I saw this different side of him that I never saw in IWC or anything like that. And he is very interesting character when he gets like that.
He has a tendency to get vicious, and you know, it's a side in him that we've always known was there. We've always known he's been this bratty, miserable kid that just wants to yell at everybody and just wallow in his own sorrows and just pretty much be a festering ball of hate. And that's exactly what he is. I mean, the bottom line is the kid is out of his head and there's no bringing him back. And I don't know what I'm going to do with him.
We got a few more here. If you could be in the Royal Rumble this Sunday, who would you most like to get eliminated by?
Greg Iron.
There you go.
That's the best answer. Go.
How's the petition coming? I haven't heard anything about the petition for a while. Did that fall out or? Because there was that big push. He was on Fox News and everything, and it was just like, where'd it go?
You know what? I don't know, really. I hadn't really talked to Gregor's personally about it, but I had caught wind that he might be getting the wrong kind of attention from it and things like that. Okay. But I don't know, I don't know any the truth to that or not. But keep on trucking, brother.
That's right. That's right.
Hopefully we'll see you Sunday.
And has Shima gone all Hollywood since being on TNA? In other words, is he growing a black and yellow beard? I know he's doing some new hairstyles that have been kind of questionable.
When hasn't Shima been Hollywood? That's the first question. When has that kid not been Hollywood? He's been Hollywood since he popped out the womb.
Oh, I didn't read the last part of the question. Black and yellow beard that he keeps in touch with hairspray.
he uses Just For Men gel.
Excellent, excellent.
That kid's been Hollywood ever since he popped out the womb in Hollywood when he was born.
And I had another one from a voicemail. I'll just play it. I'm sorry.
It's going to be fun.
All right. No. This one is the tame one. Here's one from Big Freaky.
Oh, Big Freaky.
One more question for Facade. What is the one promotion, whether it be in the States or, Japan or whatever, unfortunately WWE's probably out because you're not on gas, but, what's that one promotion that where you just look at and you see, I would be the perfect fit here. I could do so much here, yada, yada, yada. Like, where is that one promotion where it's like you feel you just have to be in?
Well, not on gas, so you're in WWE. I don't know what you mean by that, sir. But
it's Big Freaky.
I mean,
he doesn't make sense half the time, anyhow.
You should have heard the rest of the voicemails.
The two champions were straight edge guys. You know what I mean? So it's that just proves a perfect point. And guys like Evan Bourne, Kofi, all those young guys getting a chance. It's a great time for wrestling. I believe that I do have a chance in the WWE. That's the difference. I don't believe that I have to be all, whatever he said, gassed up. I don't know what that means, but drugs are bad, kids.
No one knows what Big Freaky means.
Drugs are bad. And you will get suspended if you are on drugs. So,
as we're seeing with Evan Bourne these days, as we were just talking about.
But if I had to pick an independent promotion, I think that I could really expand my horizons and have a ton of fun, that would definitely be Chikara. Mm-hmm. I feel, with my gimmick, I feel like it's... I started wrestling before I found out about Chikara. Had I found out about Chikara a little sooner, I would have probably pursued a little bit more training with them earlier in my career, because I think with my gimmick, the great mind of Mike Quackenbush could really help me flesh out a few things. You know what I mean? And I could sprinkle in the crazy badass stuff, and then I can have the fun matches, the gimmick matches, if you will, have a little bit more fun. That's what I mean. I could have a little bit more fun, take my time, and that would probably lead to a lot more longevity for me. Mm-hmm. But that's really
ninja style dance off.
there was a match that I had earlier this year in Wisconsin, La Crosse, Wisconsin, and there was a I was just refreshing my memory watching the Ninja Rap video on YouTube.
Refreshing
my memory, because I was partaking in a dance number in the match that night, and my boy Road Dogg comes up walking past, and he's like, "Oh, that's my jam." And I'm like, "Yeah, man, that's my music. That's what I come out to." And he's like, "Oh, that's awesome." And all this stuff. And I ended up doing the go. I'm not going to do it now. You got to pay for those ninja dances. But
I don't think we have enough room in here.
What? You're totally right.
A lot of equipment. We got a lot of equipment.
Yeah, this is a nice hub of electronics here that I don't want to. But I did the Ninja Rap dance, and the New Age Outlaws loved it, and they loved the match, and they really gave me some good advice too. I mean, like, that's another thing, like another opportunity where I got to put in good words and good advice from some veteran guys, and the ninja rap dance is over now, so nice. I try to use it a lot.
Nice. Has Nash seen, you talked about Nash earlier. We're talking Super Shredder.
Yeah, the Super Shredder.
So,
yeah.
I mean, you got advice from the Super Shredder.
Yeah.
And you come out to the ninja rap.
I wish at PWO, somebody out there, I do have a custom ninja rap music that I'm trying to use. I need to get Vanilla Ice, if you're hearing this. The Ice. Vanilla Ice, I need copyrights to your music. Please, let me use it.
He did it, too.
I need it wherever I'm going. At Pro Wrestling Ohio, that's the starting point. We'll use it there. Then I can use it anywhere. WWE, we'll go to JCW. I'd love to work the gathering, have Vanilla Ice come in and do my entrance music. I mean, that's insane. That's one of my goals, is working the gathering, but... to work the gathering and to have Vanilla Ice do my music, that'd be
awesome.
Thing.
Awesome, that'd be amazing. Right. I have to ask about this picture here I found on your Facebook.
Uh-oh.
You got a nice collection of belts there.
Wow, it's so icy. no, I'm just playing. I currently hold the CWE title, the Remix Pro title, and the ASW X Division title, along with the IWC Super Indy title. I'm very proud to hold all those belts, and I don't take it very lightly. I mean,
a very Ultimo Dragon pose there.
You know what? I should take a picture of it. There's this picture. I'm sure you've all seen it. The demotivational poster of Ultimo Dragon, and it says, "No matter what, no matter how awesome you think you are, you'll never be this good." And you just gotta, pull it up, Sorg. I know you don't.
Oh, I'm looking.
It's so awesome. I need it, you just look at it and you're like one more. I mean, how many? I mean, 19 more, 30 more. damn. One day. That's another guy. I'd love to work with Ultimo, man. That'd be awesome.
Is he still doing a lot these days?
I don't think so much. But that'd be really awesome. I want to do a lucha gimmick sometime. I wear an Ultimo Dragon Green Ranger shield. and like a Hayabusa mask with a Hayabusa cut and like the one eyes like this, you know what I mean?
It's
kind of crazy.
This reminds me, when we had Gargano on, we discovered the Power Ranger birthday parties you can book.
Oh my! I would like to have one of those. My birthday's already gone. Damn.
Sorry, I'm still investigating the motivational poster there.
I've actually encountered a wrestling Green Ranger one time. At IWA East Coast, he's the guy from down south. He wrestled this guy named the War Pig. And, man, that guy, he did not know the definition of being a ranger. That's all I got to say. My kung fu was better than his kung fu.
I'm failing in finding this Ultimo Dragon picture. Chat room, if you can help me out here. So
it's a toughie.
It is.
So you're talking about John May.
Oh, is that it?
That may be it, yeah.
Okay, hold on. We'll get this.
Gotta get it. It's so awesome.
Of course, the audio people don't. The audio.
Sorry, audio.
Sorry, audio. There it is. Ability. Realize right now that you'll never be this good. Nice.
If you just stare at that every day and you keep your mind to it, say your prayers, take your vitamins, don't do drugs.
The real vitamins.
Yes. Them supplements. You got to buy them at GNC. It's tough. I'm poor kid.
The Flintstone gummies.
The gummies are part of the deal. You got to take. Then you got to add the gummies. Then you got to get scoops of stuff. And then you got to like lift heavy stuff. It's very scientific.
Exactly.
I mean, I know, but I don't want to bore you with the information. You know.
It sounds like you're shopping at Baskin Robbins.
GNC 31 flavors.
Yep, 31 scoops.
Awesome. I might weigh a little more if I was eating ice cream all the time.
Awesome. Well, anyways,
no offense, I'm not going to insult you. I don't want you to. I've seen what you can do.
I'm all about variety. 36 flavors is right up my alley. But you know, just a little taste at a time.
Anyways, IWC Pure Talent this Friday in Elizabeth, PA. I'll be on DVD shortly after.
Try not to kill
that.
Me at ringside.
Try not to kill Chachi at ringside. It'll be his first day with IWC at ringside. He survived Friday night for the most part, or Saturday night this past week for the most part. So. Yeah. Of course, the big thing, the big main event is going to be Jimmy DeMarco, John McChesney in the cage match.
I'm hoping
in
to knock it.
In the cage. I'm going to put a lid on that. It's going to fall down and everybody dies. And it's
well, that's not Chachi. That's the safest match.
I'm just hoping to not get hit with any dildos. That's what I'm hoping for.
But the IWC cage match is the safest?
There will be no dildos. Come on, guys. This is a family show. That's a family show. IWC is a family show. You don't have to worry about dildos if you come to IWC shows. Okay?
I hate to argue with you. But I distinctly remember Sorg doing a dildo check.
I don't know what you're talking about.
In between matches last...
Make sure nobody trips on the next
Just streamers. There's just... there's party favors.
Oddly shaped streamers.
And that's, I know it wasn't involved.
They're not phalluses.
There's confetti. Very big confetti.
Of course, you're taking on Matt Justice for Matthew the Justice. Defending your first defense of the Super Indy
first title defense of the lovely black gold and black silver and red strap on my lap. Matthew Justice, you know, he had the Super Indy title once. That was a while ago.
He had it for like a month, right?
Yeah.
Something like that.
Matthew Justice won't get this title ever again, nor will he get another title shot. Mark my words.
And of course, the One-Nighters, the current tag team champions against Stone and Demira. That bastard Demira.
That bastard. I got a remedy for him.
Gory and Eddie Vale, as we mentioned. Oh, I didn't realize this. Founding Fathers and Gambinos is going to be in the cage? Is that right?
That's what the picture shows.
The picture seems to
indicate. The picture has a cage in the background, yes,
but
so
I'm not
know.
Sure there's, if I heard about that.
There's a caged sprite there.
There would be a cage there.
Sprite.
Actually, you can find a match, not to backtrack, but you can find a match with me and Jason Gorya slipping in easy versus Dave Demira and Chest Flexor, and on the JC Bailey tribute show from Ohio Hatchet Wrestling.
Really?
Kind of an interesting match, yeah.
Really? And of course, Ricky Shane Page against Omega Aaron Draven. Hey, Draven, that's his like maybe second or third show with IWC.
Second or third
show. I know he's over in PWO a lot.
Yeah, he's over in PWO. Ricky Shane Page might just... like, just, you know, Aaron Draven's good at, like, not good at, but he can take a few blows to the head, but Ricky Shane Page is so good at, dropping people on their head. I think Ricky Shane Page is taking that one.
Okay. There you go. This Friday. And, of course, you're, as always, involved with PWO. I know you got a few matches coming up on the TV in the next few weeks.
PWO, you will see me and Jason Gory clash horns with his demonic looks and frightening face.
He has a knife. He had a knife the back in December.
Looks like he's going to shank somebody. You ain't going to shank me.
What is that?
Man, I'm from the urban wrestling. I got people with guns.
And of course, Remix Wrestling.
Remix Pro.
I see you got a match coming up there as well.
Remix Pro. Yes, I believe it's April 7th.
April 7th. There, Jerry the King Lawler is on the card as well as Colt Cabana.
Myself and M Dog 20 for the first time one on one for that Remix Pro title.
Hurricane's on the poster. Sorry.
Oh,
I got really excited.
There's also a meet and greet with the Hurricane Helms.
Nice.
In between that time before April, just to trump up some business for Remix Pro.
Excellent.
And this Sunday, actually, the Guys Night Out show, they'll have Ricky Shane Page and Eric Ryan, myself and Lewis Linden. Chess Flexor will be floating about.
Is this AIW?
Yep.
They're having a Guys Night Out now? I know they had the Girls Night Out.
The Girls Night Out show is... is like the, you know, the main show, and the guy show is the pre-show.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, they got the pre-show going on right there before. That's a Sunday.
That's cool. I always wanted to check out these Girls' Nights Out shows.
Yeah, I mean, like,
there's not enough, like, women in indie wrestling these days, you know? I mean, IWC is always very, you know, lacking on it, it seems. We had some great stuff with Gail Kim and Tracy Brooks coming up there in Meadville, of course. But it's always been, you know, every once in a while. And
not really, like, serious women's matches go on so much in IWC. I mean,
and not much in the area, really.
Yeah.
So it's not just IWC.
Yeah.
So they may even be the most that I've seen, but definitely, you'd like to see that. I'd like to see that. At least the IW is keeping that going.
Yeah.
So, all right. Anything else you want to put out there? You got the Twitter.
The Twitter. Find me anywhere at one facade, not facade. Facade.
We will always pronounce YouTube, it facade.
One facade underground on YouTube. Trying to think if there's anything else cool or relevant. Find me on there. I'll be talking shit and putting matches up there randomly. Haven't had any. I gotta upload a new match because, you know, it's been a while since I had any new matches uploaded to my thing. But, you know, I try to just do the work and then let the DVs sell themselves. You know what I mean? I actually need to get a new 2012 best of 2011 highlight video. So if anybody out there is all good with their web magic and's got some video editing skills, hit me up. One facade. Kind of get that video made. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Sorgatron Media does great video work too. I just can't afford them because I'm a poor independent wrestler who kick fights for money.
Thank you. Thanks for joining us. Show off that belt. It hasn't been on camera much. Show that off there for the this people weekend? There. Right there. That. Right there.
It's nice and shiny.
It is shiny.
Will that be tagged?
Yeah. You're gonna have to wait and see that. I'm gonna have to wait and see. You know, I've been warned not to tag in the past, but it's never stopped me. But you know. Whenever my artwork gets cleaned up off of the belts, that's where it really makes me sore. So you know what? This one, everything should be fine. Once I get a little bored, once I'm feeling creative, once I run out of things to do, once I get pissed off, then maybe. But other than that, she's pretty how she is for now.
That's right. We're around clean for a bit. Thank you very much for joining us. Michael Facade, go check him out at One Facade and on YouTube's and this Friday, of course, at IWCWrestling.com for more information. And we're going to hit a break. We're going to see what's going on otherwheres. And we'll come back, maybe talk about a couple indie things.
Underwear.
A little bit about what's going on at WMS Gold and a little bit from this weekend at RWA. Go check it out, and we'll be right back.
Thank you, man.
And it hits. Chachi busts up laughing. I bust up laughing. Wheels busts up laughing at the DJ booth. It was just...
Five more games.
Chachi, I'm not going to... No, this dime is not going to buy you two more shares. Stop waving that dollar.
I'll give you a dollar.
No.
Sorg might be interested in the dollar.
That's fake shit. That's 100%
fake.
You cannot add another 120%.
Happy anniversary, RWA.
Are you kidding me? Hey guys, welcome back to the Wrestling Mayhem Show. This is the one and only The Rizz coming at you live on the Wrestling Mayhem Show, and we like to bring you a look back in history in a segment we like to call Remember When?
Wow.
Hey, you guys remember when the Royal Rumble was really big, and they did shows dedicated to the Royal Rumble with matches for the Royal Rumble match, as in qualifying for the match, match placement, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
We only had one match that way, and that was last night on Raw, and that was The Miz and R-Truth battling for the number one spot. or the loser gets the number one spot. So my remember when is when the Royal Rumble was like who gets what spot. Even when there was the ball rolling, that they actually had that for the bring back thing on the WWE.com. This is my second time mentioning WWE.com's bring back segment, so you're welcome.
Bring it back. But
yeah. Remember when?
Normally, I would let you go and completely agree with you. But WWE even acknowledged that this is the first time in Royal Rumble history where every superstar is eligible. So,
they said anybody that had a match earlier that night.
Right. Any superstar is eligible for the Royal Rumble.
Well, how about have, like, match placements?
Who knows? You never know. They still may do the whole lottery ball rolling thing, or, you know.
It was always presumed that that's what they did.
Yeah, in my head, they're still doing the ball roll in the back. Yeah. There's still the lottery roll thing going on. And
they're just not.
There's still some skanky bitches in the back that grab the rest.
Yeah. Like, there you go.
And there would always be a reference to that.
But
yeah, they're just not televising it.
But you know, my favorite thing about the if I can do kind of a side remember one is I love the mystery people coming out. Like we had Diesel earlier this year and Booker T out of nowhere.
That's my favorite part.
But remember the one year where they were like, we're gonna have four mystery opponents, and one was like Goldust came back, Mr. Perfect came back, and stayed for a bit. And like a couple other people, Drew Carey came one year. I mean, just random stuff like that.
Rob Van Dam showed up as a mystery guy like three times.
Yeah, exactly. It was like his yearly gig to remember how to wrestle, you know? It was just like...
remember how to wrestle.
Remember when he wrestled?
No. Yeah.
No.
Wait, he wrestled?
I don't think RVD remembered that moment.
No.
But
hey, it's the Royal Rumble. It's the start the of the Royal best time Rumble. Of the wrestling year. I mean, shit, just we got the Royal Rumble. Wonder? We got Elimination Chamber next month. We got WrestleMania. I mean, this is our wrestling holiday season.
this is the time of year where we get to unexplainably look at each other, look at a sign. Look at each other. Look at a sign.
Wait, Chachi. Wait.
It's the start of wrestling Hanukkah.
Yeah. Like,
wrestling
you know, look
Kwanzaa,
at a wrestler,
motherfucker.
Look at a sign.
8 crazy pay-per-views.
Uh-oh, is he getting a sign?
I don't know what's happening.
Look at me.
Whoa, wide shot.
Now look at the sign.
Now point at the sign.
It doesn't work the same.
And you know what? This is what we're going to do. We're going to have this shot every week from now until WrestleMania. So Chachi.
It's Chachi pointing at the sign every time that angle's up.
There you go. Chachi.
It looks like I'm staying alive.
You're going to WrestleMania.
Just go.
This is just going to be Chachi's shot now. But yeah. I
have a question.
Yes.
I have a question. Panel.
Are you going to WrestleMania?
No, my question. No. I goddamn love the Royal Rumble. It's my absolute favorite pay-per-view and my favorite time of year.
Mm-hmm.
It's the shit. So my question to you guys is, who's going to win?
Who is going to win? Well, according to the Rizz, it's going to be Tyson Kidd.
Did he win in your fantasy redo here?
Oh, he did not win in the redo.
Who won the redo?
Oh,
Christian.
Who hasn't been wrestling lately? Entrant. Okay. Well, and then what about? Or is it going to be Jericho? End of the world. Something big is going to happen. What's it going to be? I think it's going to be linked to Kane, honestly. I think something's going to happen there.
Like Jericho's possessed or something? Or
idea that somebody had where he's kind of joining up with Kane. as like the old, yeah, like this whole like Attitude Era versus current era kind of guys. I mean, I it's intriguing, and I think we saw both of them come back with very different looks and attitudes. So maybe that's connected in some weird way, but maybe. You wouldn't think so because it's so separate directions. I mean, look at the ominous way of the ads. I mean, I'm really just kind of throwing stuff at the wall here. Look at like kind of the emotional way he's coming back, and look at Kane's, you know, emotional way he's attacking John Cena.
Kane and his violence.
Yes,
emotional ways.
Maybe this is too intriguing for wrestling to pull off, but
you're going too deep.
We're going too deep.
That's what she said.
Yeah, that's it. That's it.
Actually, she never.
They never actually say that.
Yeah, they never.
No, that's okay.
So
that's never once been.
I don't know. I'll go with. I think Jericho could be a thing. Before that, there was another interesting thing that was raised. I saw on the Twitters or the Facebook or something. It might have been our own Facebook. Jericho is not embracing the hate. He's in the league with Kane. Yeah, exactly. It's just like an emotional thing.
Maybe
about
I don't know.
Everybody's eligible, including title holders.
Not title
Listen,
holders.
I so called this you, already.
Was that you?
No, not,
I
not
called
title
this
holders.
Last week.
Okay,
I said that they're gonna pull something where either. CM Punk goes into where either CM Punk enters into the Rumble and wins as the champion, or Dolph Ziggler beats CM Punk and then goes into the Royal Rumble and wins the Royal Rumble.
Wait.
Making it so that there's not anyone who's going to WrestleMania to challenge him for his title.
Wait, I know.
Because I think the storyline for that would be
so
amazing.
So he screws...
Champions can
Laurinaitis
be in the
out of
Rumble.
Main event. Go ahead, Wrestlefan, sorry.
Every wrestler is eligible, even champions.
They said champions?
Every
said
wrestler
champions.
Is eligible.
Or is this
I don't know. I thought they meant that to say the people that are wrestling in the title matches and lose, that they can be in the Rumble.
No, they just said... They just said
every wrestler is eligible.
They did.
Maybe I don't know.
But yeah, I think this if done correctly, and we all know how WWE is.
Don't hold your breath.
Right, if done correctly, I think having Dolph Ziggler win the belt and then enter the Royal Rumble as champion and win the Rumble, therefore screwing anyone from getting a title shot and possibly picking him at WrestleMania.
That'd be a good idea.
Well, somebody that's got an opinion about this is the Mad One.
Of course.
So let's go ahead and play that.
Of course he has an opinion.
Of course he has an opinion. He's got a very mad opinion, hence his namesake. Here we go. Raise motherfucker, raise the hell outside.
Get beat by about the fourth starting the Hey there, Wrestling Mayhem Show. It's Mad Mike, once again with your Minute of Mayhem. Now, the Royal Rumble's this Sunday, and I'm very excited for it, because I'm taking off a Sunday just so I can see this fucking Royal Rumble. And I got two more top five lists for you guys this week. Number five, top five possible surprise entrants for the Royal Rumble. Number five, Christian. We haven't seen Christian in a while, not since the Slammy Awards. But I think that Christian might be healed enough to make an appearance at the Rumble, and he could be a dark horse pick. Number four, Rob Van Dam. Now I know you guys are thinking, isn't he under TNA contract? Well, does anyone really care? I'm sure Rob Van Dam could have gone up to Dixie and said, hey Dixie, I need more money for weed, so I want to be in the Rumble. And she probably would have said okay, because she's a fucking idiot. Number three, John Morrison. Now I know what you guys are thinking. Again, he got fired, released, let go. But it looks like the feud between Miz and R-Truth is almost over. So why not have a Miz Morrison WrestleMania match and have it start at Mania and have it start at the Rumble? Definitely a good idea. Number two, The Undertaker. Because we haven't seen him in almost a year. He
He's always a surprise. He's always a possible surprise entrant for the Rumble, and he's always a favorite to try and get a WrestleMania title shot. Number one might be a little surprising to some people, but I think John Laurinaitis might be in the Rumble, and I think we could very well see a repeat of what happened between Vince McMahon and Steve Austin. All right, now my top five picks for the Rumble winner. Number five, The Miz. Just because Miz is entering in number one. Entering in number one, I'm sure they would love to be able to show two people that have won the Rumble at number one. And Miz has definitely come a long way, and I think he has the opportunity to do it. Number four, CM Punk. Again, I think Punk might get screwed out of his title match anyway. And if that happens, I could see Punk going into the Rumble at number two, making it all the way until number 30 comes out, Mr. John Laurinaitis, and wins the Rumble. Then, at Elimination Chamber, we have a one-on-one match between Punk and Laurinaitis for a title shot at WrestleMania. I think it'd be a great idea. Number three, Dolph Ziggler. If by some chance Punk does win, I could see Ziggler easily, as we've said before, pulling double duty and winning the Rumble anyway. And then, you know, showing off just that much more. Number two, why Barrett? Because you see, the Barrett barrage has been something that they've been pushing on SmackDown for months. And with Randy Orton coming back, it almost seems way too easy to book a Barrett-Orton title feud at WrestleMania. And that leads me to my number one pick, Randy Orton. I don't want Orton to win. I really don't. Even if I have to make a bet, I probably won't bet on Orton simply because I don't want him to win. But with him making his return this Friday on SmackDown, I'd say it's a damn good possibility he's going to win the Rumble. Well, that's it for me this week, guys. Take care. Herniated a disc. Woo, woo, woo. You know it.
Herniated a disc. He has a broken back.
Here's top five list of things I'd rather experience than John Laurinaitis versus CM Punk alone in any high-stakes match. Number five, a colonoscopy. Number four.
Wait, Chachi's doing a list?
Yes. Number four.
Save this moment.
An STD test. A non-blood STD test.
Oh.
Number three. A colonoscopy and a non-blood STD test at the same time. Number two. Raped in prison with KY jelly. And the number one thing that I'd rather have than a John Laurinaitis versus CM Punk high stakes match is a colonoscopy followed by being raped non-jelly in prison by a big black guy like Shane Taylor followed by an STD test. Non-blood.
Your obsession with Shane Taylor is amazing lately.
and then a colonoscopy.
I already said a colonoscopy.
Yeah,
he said.
Oh, okay. You have another one. Why is Chachi's title on the ceiling?
Because he's
point.
But yeah.
He's pointing at his name now.
I don't want any further storyline between CM Punk and John Laurinaitis. And you know what makes me sad? Is I'm going to get more storyline between John Laurinaitis and CM Punk.
No, I want more storyline between the two. I don't want a match.
No, I don't match. Even want storyline.
I don't want any John Laurinaitis in any form or
thank
shape.
You.
Oh, come on.
No, just
no.
Make him go away.
No,
like
you
I
know
said
what
in
this
email
is?
In the week I was getting the root canal. You know what? That root canal was infinitely more pleasurable than watching John Laurinaitis do anything.
Oh, come on.
I am dead serious. Fuck that guy.
Listen, you know what this is? This is a continuation of when CM Punk won the belt and then left.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
With a shittier person.
Point.
With a person that would make more sense for him to be angry at.
Okay. Hold on. I'm going to randomly grab things in this room within reach that have more personality than John Laurinaitis.
And go. Oh!
This is a lay with a double-sided Kennywood picture and thumb drive attached to it.
That's pretty awesome.
That's so interesting.
This has more personality than John Laurinaitis. Here is an empty... Oh, no, it's not empty. Here is a plastic wrapper with one incense in it.
Oh, interesting, because it's not empty.
This has more personality than John Laurinaitis.
That plastic bag has so much personality, it's incensed.
Here is a plain black jar lid. Has like, more...
I want what kind of jar it came from. That's interesting.
Has more personality... than John Laurinaitis.
The jar lid just doesn't have it, kid.
Wait, hold on. Wait for it.
I'm waiting.
This is a plain white piece of paper. Nothing on it at all.
You can completely, try it on it. That's so
completely
interesting.
Rectangle. Wow, this has more personality than John Laurinaitis.
That is Chachi. A perfect rectangle. Chachi. That's awesome.
There's only one way you can end this bit and go out with a bang. You're going to have to pull out one of your own pubes.
I'll do it. I will do it.
Do it.
I am doing it.
Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it.
I am never sitting on that couch again.
Scotchy's gentleman topiary.
I lost it.
Oh no.
I just lost a pew. Oh, here it is. I found it. It's stuck to the couch.
Shit.
You're gonna have to. You can't see it.
That was a pubic hair. That has more personality than John Laurinaitis.
Huh.
Do you need more? Am I done?
I'm trying to spell Laurinaitis.
Are you done?
Are you done? Are you done? I don't know what the hell else to Chachi's talk about. Done.
There's not really anything else that I can grab nearby. Here's a WMS sticker, but we all know that has more personality than John Laurinaitis.
Wow.
I would like to nominate myself for a Mayhemmy by introducing the greatest segment.
You can't nominate yourself.
Hold on. Stop. Hear my argument first.
Okay.
I'm nominating myself for a Mayhemmy under the category best segment ever had on the Wrestling Mayhem Show.
Ever.
Okay, see you next January.
I have a receipt for a purchase I made at a local gas station. This has more personality than John Laurinaitis.
Okay.
It was back funny when Chachi did it.
Everyone grabs question. Something in your room and see
the Royal Rumble. Yeah. Who do we think's going to win?
We already said that.
Did we? I don't know. I'm distracted. I just went back in time.
I'm confused. I just remember Chachi's pubes.
Chachi's pubes will win the Royal Rumble.
Okay.
All 30 of them.
They have a good chance.
Surprise entrance.
I keep hearing that they're going to put Randy Orton's going to win it. And you know what? I don't want him to win either.
No.
Oh, I got a statement from Randy Orton.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh,
give me 1 second here.
Oh, hold on. Wait. Mad Mike is right. Mad Mike is right.
I had one.
A co-award winner would be Mad Mike. Because his statement in his Mad Mike Minute of Mayhem Madness March.
Well, he doesn't get a co-award. You just have to mention him in the speech.
Mars Caban.
Okay, I have his statement.
As you can tell, I'm just naming random M words. But, yeah, Mad Mike will be a co-winner on that award.
All right, Bobby.
This is Randy Orton's statement about lack of depth in the WWE. There's not many guys in the locker room right now that I haven't worked with or that I feel I can have that big WrestleMania match with who I have not worked with that's anybody. up-and-comers are being groomed to be the next top star, but will they ever get to where I've got? Question mark? No, because you never lose to them.
That's not true. That's not true. Wade Barrett beat him a bunch of times.
Yeah, Wade Barrett got over him a little bit.
One guy. Maybe twice.
I like Wade Barrett. Chris, I don't know if I'm going on a limb there, but I like that guy. I think he's got some skills.
Hey,
he
guys.
He always wins, though.
Hey, guys.
He doesn't always...
What? Oh, point.
Point.
That's not why I wanted to... I'm looking at a candle right now, and I'm more entertained than watching John Laurinaitis.
But is the candle on a skateboard?
No, do you have a skateboard?
A pink skateboard.
Because I will put it on a skateboard.
And it will still... on a skateboard.
And it will still be better than John Laurinaitis doing anything.
Well, in other news...
Also, my pick for the Royal Rumble is Dolph Ziggler as the WWE champion.
So he wins the championship and wins the Rumble.
Yes.
Show off.
Yeah.
I like that.
That's
It goes perfect with what he's doing.
I just spoiled myself. I won't spoil you guys either.
You just spoiled yourself?
I just spoiled myself.
Did you read who wins the Rumble?
No, SmackDown.
Oh, I don't care about SmackDown.
I don't do that. How about you, Rizz? What are you thinking? Tyson Kidd?
Tyson Kidd, Christian. In all seriousness, if we don't want to pick we want to repeat ourselves. I'm thinking Daniel Bryan might do what we all think CM Punk might do. He'll lose his match and then wind up winning the Rumble for the rematch.
That would be a good one.
Could be good. Could be good.
You know, screwing, like, either the Big Show out of it, or, like, say Mark Henry won, or Big Show won, screwing the other guy out of winning the Royal Rumble.
Okay.
Look, it's clearly going to be Edge. I mean, how you guys don't see it?
It's got to be Edge. I don't know. My pick, and we mentioned it before during the Facade interview, Gregory Iron. So go with Gregory Iron. I think he takes it. Anything is possible. He takes it.
You
just wait.
You know what? Chachi's stone cold lock of the century.
Of the week.
Dolph Ziggler. As the champion. Week.
I think if Dolph, if anybody, I don't have a pick, but I think it's been.
You have to have a pick.
It's been
so long since.
Right? What happened?
Go ahead.
Nothing.
Go ahead. Sorry.
Oh, sorry.
December.
I think it's been so long since we've had somebody, like the number one or number two entrant, go all the way. I think it's time for another one of those. So if it's not the Miz, it's going to be who's ever number two, which could be Rey Mysterio.
You could see that happening to The Miz, though. You know?
Yeah, absolutely.
So, yeah, definitely.
Rey Mysterio's gone a long distance, though. My original
thought.
What's that?
That's true.
I think Jericho's going to hang out till like the last person and then come in and throw him out. He's going to be like, yeah, with the fans, and then just dump somebody over the top rope to win.
I'm still wondering what he's like. How he mentioned on Raw that it's going to be the end of the world as we know it. I really want to see how...
He's a big REM fan. What do you think?
Free t-shirts for everyone.
You're too young for that joke.
And it's still more interesting than John Laurinaitis.
Is Chris Jericho more interesting than John Laurinaitis, Chachi?
Yeah, especially since he said words.
Wait, he did say words. Jericho shoot somebody with a t-shirt cannon and knock them over the top rope.
I'm sorry, the crowd, the minute he said one word, the crowd popped so fucking loud.
That's right, that's how you build anticipation there.
Listen, the whole time, all I've wanted is him to speak. He spoke. I'm good.
And I'll be honest with you, Chachi, I wish he hadn't spoke till the Rumble. Because now it's like, okay, he spoke. Like, why was he not speaking for 3 weeks?
I don't know.
That would be too long.
How about the other matches going on here? Of course, we got CM Punk. Great stuff.
Sorg, did you do a pick?
I was calling for Jericho. I think whatever's happening with Jericho is going to lead to a win.
And Sorg are united.
Yes.
You get behind.
also reunited on the Drew Carey pick.
What?
The sleeper.
Yeah, Drew Carey's the sleeper for coming back.
I
hear he has another special to promote.
Another sleeper pick. He's in fucking good shape now, man.
Yeah, he is in great shape.
It's scary, though. It's scary. It's just like, no, you're not. You're Drew Carey. You're not supposed to be that thin.
Oh, it's like Jonah Hill.
Yeah. And apparently, Matt Mike.
It's like Jonah Hill, except Drew Carey was never funny.
Hey, you take that back.
Drew Carey show was a good show.
Whose Line Is It Anyways was a good show.
Yeah, Drew Carey
was not funny on Whose Line Is It Anyways.
Hey, we got Craig Ferguson out of the Drew Carey show, so, you know.
Okay, we got to do this. I'm sorry.
What's that?
What are you doing?
Drew Carey was funny. Oh, God.
Puppet! The only way to get through to him.
It is.
Yeah. I love you, Puppet.
Drew Carey was funny.
Your ideas are terrible.
Well, I don't remember him being funny.
Anyway, well, not watching the Price Is Rice. The Price Is Right.
Price Is Rice. The new hit Japanese game show, The Price Is Rice.
What do you got,
Josh? You play for a cup of rice.
Chachi,
Wrestlefan, your ideas are terrible.
You can't do it, Chachi. Only Bobby can do it.
That's like that game show on Saturday Night Live, Who Wants to Eat, instead of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire.
You suck. My sock puppet.
All right, you know, stuff. Yeah.
I took my sock off to totally get through to Wrestlefan.
Yes.
I took my sock off to get through to Wrestlefan.
That's still more entertaining.
And it was more entertaining than John Laurinaitis.
As you mentioned earlier, I think we talked about this afterwards, or after our interview here, but we got a three-way dance for the title again: Daniel Bryan, Mark Big Henry, Show. Big Show, in a cage!
Yes.
In a cage!
It's not going to be a good match.
No.
But it's still better than John Laurinaitis.
Also probably true, you know.
But
is this the first time they've had a steel cage match and a Royal Rumble one night?
Yes.
I can't think of any other time. Of course,
seems likely.
This is, of course, the 25th anniversary.
I'm pretty sure
so.
they pushed that fact last night during their numbers countdown.
Did they?
Probably.
Yeah, also, did you know that... there's been 87 tons of man to wrestle in the Royal Rumble? Because I had no idea before last night.
87 tons
Nor
of
did
man.
We want to know.
Yeah, I did not care that 417,000 pounds worth of man has been in that ring. I'm sorry, human. Because there's been women, too.
There have been two women in the Royal Rumble. You should have saw that. On
China and
Beth Phoenix, right?
Phoenix. That was another good surprise that happened.
61 minutes and something is the longest time spent in a Royal Rumble match.
Something around Rain 700 hysteria. People have been in there?
Yeah, 700.
Which I'm surprised. Really? The 40-minute one didn't last, or the 40-man one didn't last the longest?
Nope.
Well, no, because nobody stayed through until number
Rumble
one.
Stats.
Yeah.
And the video hasn't
over
really
62
changed.
Minutes.
The video hasn't changed in several years. No. It's just been updated.
Yes.
Yes.
New are. Numbers.
Somewhere they have a template for that, and they're just like, okay, how many people were added from last year? Here we go. How much more man was added?
It's all in an Excel document.
How many more eliminations did Kane get?
Exactly. Exactly.
Even when they did change the record for, like, you know, HBK now holds the record for most people, like, eliminated.
Mm-hmm.
They still mention Kane eliminating people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like they just added on. They're like, oh, and Kane did this too.
Although we're also going to have, I guess Santino's the shortest one now, isn't he?
Yeah, he
yeah, two seconds.
No, Santino's 1 second for the longest time spent in the Royal Rumble. That record will never be broken.
Can't really.
I don't know.
I don't know. I think the official holder of that title should be fucking Scotty Too Hotty, who was 0 seconds.
That's a good point.
Banging it.
Maven was in there for a little
while.
What
happened with Scotty Too Hotty?
Maven doesn't count as a person.
Look at his fucking eyebrows.
Hey.
But he is more entertaining than John Laurinaitis.
Maven gets the longest. I feel like we have this conversation every year about this time. But yes, Maven is the longest participant in the Royal Rumble because he never was eliminated.
Yeah. One of these years, Maven will win.
One of these years, he's going to come back. Maybe he's the one that's going to show back up, and your world's going to change. Because
Maven is going to step in that ring.
Jericho says, I have seen the light, and it is Maven.
Maven is going to step in that ring. He is going to deliver the most spectacular dropkick you have ever seen.
And he's going to sell us NFL hoodies.
You are not tough enough for this dropkick.
Yes.
He's going to sell us NFL merchandise.
And still have back. More personality than John Laurinaitis.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. Wow.
Wow. Daniel Pooter.
Daniel Pooter.
Just throwing it out there.
Yeah. Yeah, that too.
Remember when he was in the Rumble and got his ass kicked?
Yeah.
Vader.
In other news, I do want to bring this up. You guys have you guys seen what's going on with ROH Wrestling and Chikara lately?
Yeah.
I mean,
this is indie wrestling.
It's kind of indie wrestling, but it's on TV.
We already said no indie wrestling.
It's on TV.
Shut up.
This is TV. This is Chikara getting on TV, and this is really intriguing. Now, Wrestlefan, you've been following this, right?
Well, I was following, yeah. The big thing was that they're going to do like some sort of synergy show. I believe in April in Chicago with ROH and Chikara, so that's going to be like a big thing. One of their past shows, though, they had a match where they have these things now in ROH called proving ground matches, which are basically non-title matches, and if the challengers win, they get a title shot.
Mm-hmm.
So Jigsaw and Hollow Wicked from Chikara faced the Briscoe brothers, defeated the Briscoe brothers. And so now they will get a title shot at the big ROH Chikara Synergy event. And apparently there's a big altercation. The Briscoes coming out and saying, we didn't expect to be fighting ants and baseball players or whatever the hell they were. Kind of escalated into something bigger. So there's a chance there may be a little feud going on between Ring of Honor and Chikara. Kind of like what they did a couple years ago with Ring of Honor and CZW. I really hope that's what it turns into. It's going.
Bed of pants.
Yeah. I will say that when it was Ring of Honor and CZW, it was two very different companies. I mean, because you look at what Ring of Honor is all about and CZW, they're two completely different things. But then you look at Ring of Honor and Chikara, and yes, Chikara has the over-the-top characters, but they're still focused a lot on wrestling and a lot on, you know, that kind of style.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm really wondering what's going to, you know, happen with this whole thing. It should be, I'm interested to see what comes up from it. Hopefully it'll get, you know, Chikara guys a bit more spotlight, which that would be nice. I'm really going to keep an eye out and see what's going to happen with that.
There's a lot of people with masks in that ring.
I think the only one that doesn't have a mask is Mike Quackenbush.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
There's a lady in there, too.
With a mask.
Yep.
She have
and
a
you
mask?
Know what?
She does.
It is more interesting than John Laurinaitis.
Right. It's infinitely more
but
interesting.
But either way, this is Chikara finally. This is the first time Chikara's been on TV in general.
I don't know if it was on TV. I wonder if they may feature it on the TV show. But this was for like a DVD, one of the DVD events.
Oh, this
events.
Is a DVD show?
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they talk about it on the television show, though.
Okay. Cause, well, the way I was looking with the logo, I thought it was their television program.
Tell you what, if it's on a DVD, I'll buy it.
Yeah. Well, either way, this is a great company for Chikara to be in, of course, with Ring of Honor. Because Ring of Honor is getting, you know, a more national exposure with their latest TV deal. And I was speculating earlier about you know, what is this going to lead to? Like, is this something where maybe Chikara will be investigated for a deal with, was it Sinclair Broadcasting?
And have more
are we going to see? Are we going to see Chikara TV show here in the future if this keeps panning out?
I don't think they would.
I mean, well, they're already dealing with Ring of Honor, which is now owned by that broadcasting company. So there has to be a little bit of stuff going on there.
I don't think they would put two wrestling shows or wrestling companies on the same channel.
You don't think?
I wouldn't be surprised.
I agree.
Was that
Spike?
Was that LB?
No, not Spike. Cartoon Network.
That would be awesome.
Well, remember that back in the day.
Yeah, they did have something like that.
Back in the day, Kaiju Big Battle was on G4.
I will say, Kaiju Big Battle was a little bit different than Chikara.
Yeah, it was a little
fact
more over the top.
That they wrestle in giant suits.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
they wrestle in a ring that's depicted to look like a city,
mm-hmm,
with buildings inside of the ring.
But,
that's phenomenal.
But I do believe Galvin Loudspeaker was the announcer on that, so
he's
already had
he
some
was,
TV
yeah
time.
And they definitely had a relationship, but I think Chikara's a lot like Ring of Honor.
It's like that perfect, it's that perfect mesh halfway between Kaiju Big Battle and Ring of Honor, I think. Because we got the wrestling, the actual good wrestling, they had good matches, great matches, but we have the over-the-top storylines, and they meet somewhere in the middle, and we just accept giant ants.
I wouldn't be surprised if Chikara, like, and ROH do form like a little pact, and they're both on the ROH network, show.
Mm-hmm. Maybe they get featured every once in a while. Or
yeah,
you,
they'll
you know
be like their own little brand on the side, but it's still on TV, and they'll get exposure to that.
I think it'd be great. I mean, we already see Chikara branching out in iPay-per-views. Which, you know, it's a lot easier to get an iPay-per-view, I think, than a DVD these days, you know, for the price and ease of use and everything. So, and I think that's where a lot of those are going. Either way, this is good for wrestling. This is what everybody talks about, you know?
And I noticed that they're doing the doubleheader with ROH. They're doing the doubleheaders with a couple different companies.
Mm-hmm.
They're doing one with ROH. They're doing one with JAPW.
Okay.
They're kind of, and I know they've done ones with AIW in the past. I wonder if this is, you know, Chikara, and it's definitely much bigger than what they've done in the past. But I'm wondering how, you know, they're going to fit in with the whole thing.
Well, you know, a lot of these companies, it's hard to run a show in a new state, you know, and that's why you see like AIW Chikara, you know, doing a doubleheader like we've seen before. You know, it's a matter when you do a new state of, like, getting the license in that state.
Right, yeah.
I know there's a little bit about that.
Chikara's ventured out, I think, since they lost ECW Arena.
Mm-hmm.
They've definitely had to venture. They've done shows, I believe, in, like, Connecticut.
They've done New York.
They've done, I think they're doing Canada soon.
And it could be something where, you know, losing the ECW arena gets them out of their comfort zone to do these other great things. So
mm-hmm.
You can look at it that way. What's up, LB?
Guys, I just had an amazing idea.
Hmm.
Okay.
It's
so
already better than John Laurinaitis.
Cartoon Network. Oh, way better. Orders of magnitude better. Listen. Okay, so Cartoon Network plus Chikara, right?
Yeah.
Cartoon Network's worked with wrestling before. They had a cartoon named Mucha Lucha, and in Mexico or Spain or some fucking other country, what's the super famous luchador wrestler, dead guy?
El Santo.
They had an El Santo cartoon in the style of Samurai Jack, which was awesome. But picture this. Cartoon Network gets it, but it runs on Adult Swim.
They have Mongo Wrestling Alliance cartoon.
Adult Swim.
That. Yeah.
Runs Chikara and two new wrestlers. And they'll be the best
I know where you're going.
Company in the world. Space Ghost.
RV. <Yeah. laughs>
And Brack could be an announcer. I think there's a lot of opportunity. I mean, look at the stuff that Chikara's put out so far. There was the of course the Color Toons app. You know, really kind of putting over them as like these are cartoon characters. I don't know if any of you guys have seen the trailer. I don't know what happened to the video game, but with the King of Trios that we attended not last year, but the year before in 2010. They debuted a trailer for a video game that's supposed to be upcoming.
It's still in the process,
but it was like a very animated, you know, kind of thing happening. So, they're perfect for it, what the characters that they have.
Adult Swim.
So there you go. I don't think you'd even have to be Adult Swim.
That's true. Yeah.
You know, I mean, because Chikara is like for everybody. It really is for everybody, and you could put that on like a Saturday night slot or something like that. And I think it will be. I mean, it is wrestling that you know, you can watch with your kids, you know.
Yeah. And
not be ashamed of it. I mean, it's the Shrek of professional wrestling.
It's fun in the way that it needs to be.
Yeah, yeah. The way it needs to be, where it should be, you know, and not ashamed of it, you know. Ring of Honor is the sport of wrestling. This is the over-the-top and character of wrestling. NXT is the complete fucking soap opera of wrestling. I'm sorry, I watched it today.
But NXT is amazing.
Dude, NXT may be the best thing that WWE's putting out right now. Because there's no fucking excuses on NXT for anything that they do.
I get to see Trent Beretta and Yoshitatsu and Tyson Kidd put on great matches, then I'm fine.
There's good matches there, and they had their 100th episode, and listening to
the
Michael
wedding
Cole,
was awesome.
Listen to Josh Matthews and Michael Cole talk about how ridiculous the show is, and like, I don't know, like what happened to these redemption points? I don't know. We really don't kind of pay attention to them anymore. There's so much inside talk going on there. It was just like, I don't understand why this guy's still here. You know, it's just like, how long is this?
Oh, I know.
How long has the season been going?
Over a year.
How did Matt Stryker get power? He's like, you know, I never really figured that out. It's like, it was
Matt
Stryker,
the GM
Please,
of NXT.
Go watch that last episode of NXT with the wedding from Las Vegas and everything. You will be pleased.
I will say, I love the way, I didn't get to see the whole video. I saw like some of it. My best, I gotta say, Johnny Curtis wearing the Tux t-shirt.
Yes,
and then
to the wedding.
Maxine, who, oh my god, they need to bring her up to the main roster. I think she's one of the more talented in-ring and on the mic of the Divas, was wearing a fishnet wedding dress.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say it right now.
When fucking, what's his name, kind of became GM because nobody was paying attention. Stevie Richards.
What?
Game GM. No one was paying attention.
Rizz, what were you saying?
I said they need to bring Derek Bateman up.
Dude, like, yeah, they're doing great stuff with them. There was one line that just had me cracking up when I watched it earlier today. He's
right at the end when he.
Yeah, when he went and interrupted and he was like rhyming stuff, it was like that's hilarious. I see why everybody's up on this guy. It was pretty good. It's pretty good.
Yeah, but
Chachi, you should watch NXT.
What?
You should watch NXT.
No.
I'm telling you.
Dude,
you'll appreciate it.
It's worse than indie wrestling.
No, it's not worse than indie wrestling.
So I was outside.
It's better than a whole lot of indie wrestling.
I was outside.
Yes.
And I found this paint chip.
are you gonna eat it?
And guess what?
You're not going to eat it, are you?
It's more interesting than John Laurinaitis.
Seriously, Chachi. NXT, I think you'll like NXT because, like you said, the wrestling aspect, it's very indie wrestling-esque, and then you have the production of WWE.
Damn it.
I think
you're using my own arguments against me, and I don't like it.
Look at the production. Look
that's
at the fishnets. That's a wedding dress.
Oh, and that's a Tux t-shirt.
That's
son
it.
Of a bitch.
With a leather jacket.
You're using my arguments against me.
But he also likes the party.
How dare you?
That's right.
How dare you use my words against me? It's time to wrap it up.
I really hope that this gives them a chance to get some of the Chikara guys that I think deserve to be in Ring of Honor in there. Like, they use Mike Quackenbush a couple times in ROH, but only for, like, you know, to put this guy over or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think they used Eddie Kingston properly when he was in ROH. I hope they, you know, do something with that. You know, hell, the Ants, and, you know, I even Johnny Gargano, you know, who's one half of the tag champions in Chikara, you know.
Excellent.
So, hey, Sorg.
Hey, that's me.
What'd you learn from wrestling this week?
Shit, did I learn some shit from wrestling this week? Gee, what can I talk about? I learned. Why would you use a song that's definitely on WWE commercials? First of all, Wheels, I don't know if he's in the chat room, but like, was he using that music before the commercial came out? Then there's an excuse there. But other than that,
hold on.
Also, I want to put in
on the music tip.
Yeah, yeah.
Since you're talking about music the RWA used.
Yeah.
Okay, so there was the WWE commercial dubstep song.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
But I don't know the name of the song. But it's the one about writing you a love song.
What? What's up to that?
Oh, No, that one tag team came up to a mashup of that I write you a love song, whatever the fuck.
Oh, yeah, called. Yeah. And with
I'm not gonna write you a love song.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. And then it was mashed with Shipping Up to Boston by the Dropkick Murphys.
Yeah, that was their two theme songs, and they just mashed them together when they teamed up.
And it was the most interesting music I've ever heard. I actually kind of dug it. It wasn't bad.
But, too bad they broke up that ahead. Night, right?
Yeah, so, they broke up.
That's what I say. I mean, there was a lot of learning this weekend. There was a whole lot of learning. And
Are you flicking us off, Sor? No.
Oh, no, there's another finger.
Yeah, there's two.
Oh, fingers. There's another finger.
Hey, Wrestlefan?
I just saw one.
Sorry about that.
Are you done?
I'm done.
Okay, Wrestlefan? Yes. What did you learn from wrestling this week?
I learned from wrestling this week because browsing around, the internet and stuff like that. I learned Ezekiel Jackson has hair.
Yeah!
When did that happen?
I think he grew it because he's tired of everyone saying he's the new Ahmed Johnson.
But he's better than Ahmed Johnson.
All right. Hey, Lunchbox?
But a fucking blasphemy. That was fucking blasphemy. What you don't talk about Ahmed Johnson like that.
I just did, sir.
What did you learn from wrestling this week?
I learned two things. One, that root canals are not as bad as I've been led to believe my entire life. And two, that the Royal Rumble never fails to get me excited.
Mm-hmm.
Bobby?
You're hard right now.
I learned that Randy Orton never loses. And Chris Jericho can fire a hell of a t-shirt.
Hey, Rizz?
I learned that we went from having the Hulk Hogan beat the Iron Sheik for the world title for the United States to having Ted DiBiase beat Unico in a flag match that means nothing for America.
America. America. What did the chat room learn?
Chat room, I'll look chat out. Room. Chachi, what'd you learn?
Chachi,
I learned several things this week in wrestling, Michael. Number one.
Michael?
Yes.
Michael?
Who's Michael?
Number one.
Michael Facade, he left.
Number one. Anything I point out is more interesting than John Laurinaitis.
Wait, point. You got a point?
Chachi.
Number two.
Chachi.
Yeah.
Am I more interesting than John Laurinaitis?
Believe it or not, Wrestlefan, you are not more interesting than John Laurinaitis.
You can go fuck yourself with that one.
Number two. If I'm going to keep filming ringside for wrestling, I should probably warm up with the wrestlers beforehand because the next morning, I felt like Shane Taylor destroyed me.
Didn't I tell you to stretch?
You did.
You were like, I'm going to go get a cigarette. I'm like, you should probably stretch out.
Yeah, I didn't. And I paid for it. I felt like I got beat the hell out of.
Mad Mike learned that Zack Ryder will be stronger than Batista if he can come back from getting put through the stage.
Ooh.
And he's the only one in the chat room, so that's it.
Okay.
I guess so.
So, you know how to get in touch with us. You can visit us at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can catch us on the Twitters at Mayhem Show. Google Plus us. Monday night hangouts for Raw. No wangs. Absolutely no wangs. Boobs, no wangs.
Unless your name is Wang.
Yeah, your last name.
WrestlingMayhemShow.com.
You can also email us.
You can also email us at at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. And I would
have a Facebook page.
I would tell you the phone number, but I do not know it.
I would say that's 412-206-WMS0.
And so, Matt
9670.
Yeah. And what's that, Riz?
And so, Mad Mike doesn't have a fit. We have a Facebook page that we are pushing very, very hard.
They're going to say very awkwardly.
I stopped following
very
the Facebook
awkwardly.
Page.
Why you stopped following the Facebook page?
Because I'm in the middle of ChachiPlays.com. I do not need your bullshit cluttering up my stream.
ChachiPlays.com.
ChachiPlays.com.
Well, you should. All the rest of you should follow Wrestling Mayhem Show after ChachiPlays.com on the Facebook.
If you want to get to the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook page, all you have to do is go to ChachiPlays.com and click on that donate button. And for a donation, it'll take you automatically to the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook page.
I still want my donuts, Chachi.
I'm thinking that's a lie.
Disclaimer alert. Clicking on the donate button will not take you to the WrestlingMayhemShow.com page.
No. WrestleFan is at the WrestleFan. DJ Lunchbox is at the DJ Lunchbox. He's also at monsterhaiku.org. We'll have more information about that here in the coming weeks.
Lies.
Stay tuned to awesomecast.com in a couple weeks.
Lies.
And Bobby F. J-Town.
Lies.
He's still in J-Town.
Everyone. Still in J-Town. Everyone is at ChachiPlays.com.
Rizz is at RizzIUP.
ChachiPlays.com.
ChachiPlays.com.
I can do the Sabu.
Sorg's on ChachiPlays.com.
I am
Everyone also, is at ChachiPlays.com.
SorgTronMedia.com for all the crazy stuff going out. So much going on. So
by the app.
By the app, ladies and gentlemen. I want to give a big thanks to our guest tonight, Michael Facade.
ChachiPlays.com.
He's at one facade on your Twitters, so go check him out.
You can check him out on ChachiPlays.com.
You can check out Michael Facade on ChachiPlays.com.
You can find things that are more entertaining than John Laurinaitis at ChachiPlays.com.
That's right.
There were pictures of me in a dress.
Those had to go away.
Yeah, funny story about that. I actually had to edit those pictures because you could see my wang bulge.
Chachi's Wang Bulge. More interesting than John Lauren.
All right, thanks everybody. That's the Mayhem for tonight. Wang, we'll see you guys next week. Mayhem.
Mayhem out.
ChachiPlays.com.
Chachi Wang Bulge. Just wait.